So do you guys own a home here in Kelowna? Or maybe you're just interested to see what the real estate market is like right now. Or maybe you're a developer. Maybe you're just looking for investments. This is a great place and a great city to invest your money. And I'm gonna go into the reasons why. And I was there before. I moved from outside, from Saskatchewan, and I moved right here into the central Okanagan. And in this video, I'm gonna go over what the current real estate market is like, and where there's winners and where there's losers. Right now, currently, as of September 2021, at the month end. If you haven't already, please hit that like button and hit that subscribe button to just to make sure you don't miss out on any future videos living in Kelowna. So looking at the market overall in September, you know, I don't think we really saw the initial uptick what we normally thought we would see. Maybe it's a mix of cold and flu season. Maybe the election, the recent early election, really played a role to really hold people back. But whatever market you're looking into, there's always winners and there's losers. And the best option you can do is really just take the cards you have currently and play them the best you can. And in a nutshell, I mean, the real estate market is really just like any other market. It really just boils down to supply and demand. So the amount of supply, and depending on the demand, will dictate the price. And so assuming the demand is the same, a low supply of inventory will increase an upward pressure in prices. Flipping that around, if you see considering demand the same, a higher supply will also bring a reduction in the actual over prices. So, and this is the market, what we're really seeing right now is the low supply and a high demand right now. 50% of the buyers in the central Okanagan are coming from outside the central Okanagan. So half the amount of people purchasing here is really based on coming in here and doing their thing and investing in the Okanagan. Right now in the central Okanagan for September, there's 567 total sales, which was up from 560 sales in August. And pretty close to the five-year average of 541 sales. So that's really, those numbers really haven't changed a whole lot. But these numbers here right now, so the total number of active listings is at 1,363 new listings. This is compared to the five-year average for September, and that's 2,625. So we're sitting right now with the amount of active listings, about 52% of where the market normally is based on the five-year average. And that's really putting, what's really putting the upward pressure on pricing. Until we start to see the supply increase and demand really drop quite a bit, we're not really gonna see a really relief, in my opinion, on pricing. Prices are gonna continue to go up based on the lack of supply and the demand. People need homes to live in, everybody has their things. So looking at the single family home market, that's the one driver that really is people are really benefiting in the most, because at higher price points, often the average price is now up to $1,079,000. That's based on the, and that's up from the five-year average of $776,000. So we're seeing a substantial increase in home prices, $250,000, $300,000 in average home price sales. A lot of number in things that are factored into this, which go into the supply and demand, low interest rates, other economical factors as well, is really driving it. And the natural beauty that the Okanagan has is really driving where the demand and supply and where those lines intersect. And so those are the really winners, the single family home people that are maybe even looking to downsize on that or move to something a little bit bigger. You can still win in that. When you're looking at the real winners though, are, you know, the for buyers, it would be getting into either the pre-builds, so you buy now and you don't take hold of it, so you're buying at today's pricing, however you're not taking possession of it and you're only down your deposit until the completion of the project, which could be 1 year, 2 years, 3 years out. So pre-builds are a place where you can actually really set yourself ahead and get a jump on that market, where when you do take the possession of it and you have to put the remaining funds out, so you're just only out, you know, the 10% for the deposit, but when you take possession of it, then you do have the full benefit and the full appreciation of what the market has done in the last 3 years, and you don't even have to close on it. You can either flip it before taking advantage flip it, so you could assign your contract to another buyer and before completion, so you don't have to pay lawyer's fees, that sort of thing. So that's where we're seeing some people take advantage of this market and win. That's more of a long term, but obviously people, that's an investment play. Obviously people are need a place to live. So one of the places where you can win in this market is either moving towards the townhome market. That is a market that is really gonna be up, going up. People are trying to move away from the apartment buildings. And what we're really seeing is a lot of people looking to get into the townhomes. So townhomes, and the city of Kelowna has a lot of development and a lot of things happening in it. A lot of things that they're trying to create a better place and more homes for everybody to just create a little bit more affordability. And so there's areas in Kelowna where there's future development. And sometimes you can get a pre-build there that you can make a purchase on it, and it's not going to be completed until 6 months out because it's a fourplex, right? But you're getting taken advantage of these. It doesn't have to be a huge tower build. You can take advantage of the townhouse market and where the future is, because all these higher development plays are also in good, are normally in really good location. So downtown area or by the hospital, where your investment is really going to appreciate probably the fastest, and you know, it can be a safe bet. And obviously people are sometimes, even at that rate, with those townhomes, are getting priced out of that market as well. But that's where you can move into, maybe moving into micro suites or micro condos. But then, you know, that's the opposite end of the spectrum where you're going in a little bit too small. So I think where the real winners are just finding those 3-bedroom condos close to transit. So you could be in the Rutland area, places that are growing and really a lot of transit to it. And whether it's just for a short term, just so you can get your feet wet, that is the play I like a lot, is either getting into condos like the Verve, you know, just where there's a lot of them, and that supply keeps the prices down slightly, but we're starting to see those prices increase there. And then also close to the university would be another market where you can get into. So I hope you got some takeaways from this chat here and from this video. If you please hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. I'd love to hear from you. Send me your feedback. Send me your questions. If you do have questions on the real estate market, feel free to reach out. That's what I'm here for. Take care.